Hey guys, NYKia31 here, shifting gears a little bit for some hoops. NBA Live 15, game number... I'm not sure what game this is, but still on the Knicks. Haven't lost yet, so we're taking on the Portland Trail Blazers. We'll see if the Knicks streak continues, or we move on to the next team if I take an L. And I'm taking on the Portland Trail Blazers. Should be a tough matchup. Damian Lillard, Marcus Aldridge, solid team. And I've pretty much, as you can see here, settled on this baseline cam. I really like it. And for some reason, the audio's a little bit out of sync at the first few minutes of the video, but I'm not off to a good start here as I missed the step back J with Melo, and he scores in the open court. And when I'm down to Samuel Dalembert taking a shot with a shot clock winding down, that's kind of not what I have in mind, but, you know, I get the bucket, and Lillard just posterizes somebody, so he's come out pretty strong. And Melo has come out pretty cold. That's not good. I gotta get Melo rolling. And he can reverse in transition. He is up 9-6. I have the shot winding down again. And I'm having bad guys taking tough shots. Get the turnover there off the break. And Quincy Acey doing some basket hanging. I suppose if you missed a shot, you might as well cherry pick, I guess. So we'll see how long this guy plays with a brain, or whether he's just going to be a L-stick spammer with Lillard and play the usual online defense that you see in these basketball games. Just swiping with the steal button or roaming around like a headless chicken with one guy. No one in these basketball games seems to understand the concept of simply just staying in front of your guy. They create more problems than they actually do helping their own defense, because they're constantly taking their team or putting their team in bad position with their, you know, reckless freelancing. So it's 13-12. Trying to get into a rhythm. Nice cut there by Dalembert. So I actually had the lead now for the first time, but that's short-lived, and Lillard hits a contested three, so back and forth we go, and here comes the full court pressing. This is a good way to get your defense broken down and give up quick points, but, you know, I got Pablo Brigioni in there now, he can't really push the ball, and a nice little backdoor cut and lob. Carmelo to Shump, another turnover. I turned the ball over a lot this game, and that, of course, leads to a breakaway. And he converts. So we got to tighten up the offense and fend off the paint pounding. Nice pick and roll there. Chris Kamen doing some work. So why the heck am I playing on this camera angle as opposed to the broadcast angles from the side perspective? The only reason, well, not the only reason, but the main reason is I just love the arena detail. I love the way the arenas look, and I like the, ouch, there we go, Melo. Well, and I also like that it's easier to be more direction relative. Well, two reasons, really. Melo on the pick and fade, step back for the three-pointer, so we're starting to get Melo rolling and we're tied up. Get the steal, we get a steal of our own. JR put someone on the poster, my goodness. This game is really aesthetically pleasing. It's really fun to play. So we're going to try to convert this and one. So maybe that'll be the spark that ignites the firestorm. Melo in the high post. He leans the wrong way. Two-handed flush. So we're cooking a little bit now. Pick and roll. Tries to force. No forcing in the paint for you, and JR again. So JR Smith comes off the bench and starts doing some igniting. We're up six all of a sudden going into the fourth quarter. Bad shot. should have either done a step back or just pass it out. There he's got Wesley Matthews in the game, along with Lillard, Robin Lopez, Blake, and LaMarcus Aldridge. He hasn't used LaMarcus Aldridge much at all. He's pretty much been riding the Lillard and Wesley Matthews bus. Shump. So I'm up 53-45 now as he's become increasingly dive into the paint and three-point reliant, and I don't get the charge there. I couldn't tell if I was too deep or whether, you know, the law of averages went against me, but either way, Batum gets a three-point play. So now we got Melo heating up. LaMarcus Aldridge on Melo. Away from the basket, we make him dance, and we get the and one. Melo is a problem as a small ball four. He can't be guarded away from the basket off the dribble. He has 25 points now to having maybe like two in the first quarter. The MVP chance rain from the rafters of MSG. I miss a pair of free throws with J.R. Smith, so that gives him a gasp of life. Wesley Matthews. And that's one of the things in the Knicks lack. They lack that enforcer in the paint that can block those or force misses around the rim. So, he still has some hope. And a lot of hope. He has to pretty much go in a three-point barrage and get a lot of turnovers off of steals, which I intend to prevent. There, I take a chance and reach, and that opens up the pick and roll. So, he's doing most of his damage with Lillard in the paint and on three-pointers with Lillard and Johnson and pick and rolls. Hasn't really gone to Aldridge much at all, and I thank him for it. Desperation mode now, just scrambling for three-pointers, and he makes that one off the offensive rebound. Jeez. Another contested three. That's a miss. And we're just going to try to finish it out in style. We try to go for the lob. We don't connect, so the Knicks pull this one out. It was looking like a struggle for a while there, but I clamped down defensively, got Melo rolling once that happened. Was able to pull away, so the Knicks train keeps on rolling. Talk to you all later. Peace.